إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، أفضل الذكر لا إله إلا الله، وأفضل الدعاء الحمد لله، وأفضل العمل اتباع السنة. أيها الأحبة في الله، الناس هلك إلا العالمون، والعالمون هلك إلا العاملون، والعاملون هلك إلا المخلصون. فما ارتفع شيء إلى السماء أعظم من الإخلاص، وما نزل شيء من السماء أعظم من التوفيق، وبقدر الإخلاص يكون التوفيق. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يوفقنا لما يحبه ويرضاه. أيها الأحبة في الله، أصعب شيء على النفس طلب العلم، وأصعب شيء على النفس بعد طلب العلم فهم العلم، وأصعب شيء بعد الفهم التطبيق. وأنت مخلوق لهدف، فاعلم وتعلم حتى تعرف ما لك وما عليك. My dear brothers and sisters, the best of all remembrance is to say لا إله إلا الله. And the best of all dua is to say Alhamdulillah. And the best of action is to follow the footsteps of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Everyone is at danger except knowledgeable people. And knowledgeable people are at danger if they don't apply what they know. And those who apply what they know are at danger if they are not sincere. Nothing ascends to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more accepted and bigger and better than being sincere with your acts. And nothing descends from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bigger and more beneficial than tawfiq, helping you and guiding you to do good. And this good is sincere and according to the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Otherwise, it is not good and it's not accepted. It has to be for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it has to be according to the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We know that seeking knowledge is not an easy thing. It's very hard on the self to control yourself, to sit, to be quiet, to obey, to understand, to ask, to review, and to apply, and to call for. It's not an easy task. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored the people who have knowledge, and He put them closer to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala set examples for us in the Quran, and he said, knowledgeable people are the one who can understand and reflect upon those. So each and every one of us, when you read something in the Quran, you don't understand it, then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make you from the knowledgeable people. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Those people who really know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the one who love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and balance between the two. You are created for a noble cause, and this noble cause, you should know it. And therefore you should seek the knowledge to understand what do you have to do and what do you get when you do. What do and what you get when you do. And we all know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran, which is al-Quran, Nur, والقرآن شفاء، والقرآن حياة، والقرآن سعادة. فكما قيل: كم أقرأ من القرآن؟ قال له العالم أو الشيخ: كما تريد، اقرأ كما تريد أن تكون سعيدة. When one person was asked, how much should I read Quran? He said, as much and the way you want to be happy. إذن نجعل هذا القرآن كالهواء، تلاوة وفهما وحفظا وتطبيقا وتعليما. So we should make the Quran and the relationship, our relationship with the Quran, just like you breathe air. You should read it, understand it, apply it, memorize it, and call for it, and live your life with it. You will be alive, and you will be happy, and you would know the purpose and the cause why you are here, which we all know. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. You are created for no other cause or no other purpose but to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We all know that, but how many of us are really fulfilling that purpose? How many of us wait and delay and postpone, and they say, I will, and I will, until it is too late? أكثروا من ذكر هادم اللذات. Death can be here any minute. So never say I will, but act when you can, and give when you can, and draw yourself closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if this is your last minute. When we pray, what do we say? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us and commanded us, صلي صلاة مودع. Pray like you're saying goodbye to this world. And if you are praying your last prayer, naturally you're going to be attentive and you're going to do it according to the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. عندما نتكلم عن القرآن نتكلم عن يوم الجمعة. ومن سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه كان يقرأ سورة الجمعة وسورة المنافقون في يوم الجمعة. When we read the Quran, we find out that there is a surah named for today, because this is the best day the sun rose upon, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sunnah, he used to constantly recite Surah Al-Jumu'ah and Surah Al-Munafiqun, which is two surahs right after each other. And you probably or should wonder why. Because another, he used to alternate with also Surah Al-A'la and Surah Al-Ghashiyah, so you know that it is not the only one. Why did he alternate, and why he chose those surahs? Surah Al-Jum'ah, naturally, today is Friday, and the surah is named for the day Friday. And in the surah, there is an example. In the surah, there is an example, a horrible example that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set for people who have knowledge and they don't apply and benefit from the knowledge. And also Surah Al-Munafiqun, surah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about hypocrites. And we will tell you the relationship between today and that, inshallah. Today the title of the khutbah, أسوأ مثالين في القرآن. The worst two examples Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set in the Quran for people who don't benefit from the knowledge that they should seek. So you can imagine if you don't have the knowledge, that's even worse. So you get the knowledge and you apply the knowledge. Two horrible examples, one in Surah Al-A'raf and one in Surah Al-Jumu'ah. سورة الأعراف يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى واتل عليهم نبأ الذي آتيناه آياتنا فانسلخ منها فأتبعه الشيطان فكان من الغاوين ولو شئنا لرفعناه بها ولكنه أخلد إلى الأرض واتبع هواه فمثله كمثل الكلب إن تحمل عليه يلهث أو تتركه يلهث ذلك مثل القوم الذين كذبوا بآياتنا فاقصص القصص لعلهم يتفكرون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about a scholar from Bani Israel, from the Israelites, that some of the mufassirin said that he was mustajab al-da'wah. He makes dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts his dua, very knowledgeable and very righteous. And the people ask him to make dua against Prophet Musa alayhi salam and the believers with him. And he refused. He said, woe to you. They have a prophet amongst them. What are you talking about? So they continued on pressuring him. And they enticed him with some worldly gain, money and such. So he made dua against the prophet. And the dua fell on the people, not on the prophet. Whatever he says against Prophet Musa alayhi salam and the people, it goes on his people. And they told him, you're actually making dua against us, not for us. The point is, knowledgeable, but his knowledge is sold for this dunya. Just like you find people selling the masajid and selling their religion and selling their conscience for something they want to gain. Let it be a status, let it be reputation, let it be money. They do that. So this knowledgeable scholar did that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave an example of him, which is number one, horrible example, the dog. إِن تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْهِ يَلْهَثْ أَوْ تَتْرُكْهُ يَلْهَثْ. Now, you have a dog. What is he doing 24/7? Panting. Whether you put him inside or outside, carrying something or not carrying something, left alone or not, he's panting all the time. So this scholar, with his knowledge, it is to advise him. So whether he has this knowledge or doesn't have the knowledge, he is the same panting for this dunya. The knowledge did not benefit him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set a horrible example for a person who does the same thing like this person. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said at the end, سَاءَ مَثَلًا الْقَوْمُ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا وَأَنفُسَهُمْ كَانُوا يَظْلِمُونَ. What a horrible example for the people who disbelieve in the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they are doing wrong to themselves. So this is number one. You have knowledge, you're not applying the knowledge, it's not benefiting you, whether you have a reminder or no reminder. Whether someone tells you taqillah or no one tells you taqillah, you're the same person, bad and far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Somebody recites an ayah or a hadith to make you change your status for, let it be a difference of opinion, let it be a dispute, let it be anything. It doesn't matter. I give you a surah or an ayah, you are the same. Your mind is stuck. Nothing benefits you. That is the example of the dog. هذا الإنسان يكون بهذا الخلق متصرف كما يتصرف الكلب. فمثله كمثل الكلب. إن تحمل عليه يلهث أو تتركه يلهث. هذا أول مثال. المثال الثاني هو قول الله سبحانه وتعالى مثل الذين حملوا التوراة ثم لم يحملوها كمثل الحمار يحمل أسفارا بئس مثل القوم الذين كذبوا بآياتنا. The example of the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Torah on them is like the example of the donkey who carries books, volumes of books. What does he get from it? What does the donkey benefit from those books? Do they guide him? No. So he's carrying guidance, but he's going nowhere. This is like a camel in the desert, loaded with water, loses his owner. What happens to the camel? Dies. From what? From thirst. And he is what? Loaded with water. But he's not benefiting from it. So the example, you have a Quran. I mean, here you have a Torah, a book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَا التَّوْرَاةَ فِيهَا هُدًى وَنُورٍ. So it is a guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the time of Prophet Musa alayhi salam. They didn't benefit from it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set that example. He said, the person who has the knowledge and did not benefit from that knowledge is like the donkey who did not benefit from the books that he is carrying on his back. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala fi hadith inna allaha yubghidu kulla ja'dhariyin jawwab sakhabun bil aswaq jifatun bil layl himarun bin nahar alimun bi amri ad-dunya jahilun bi amri al-akhirah. Another donkey example for a person who's mashallah, every degree he earned it, but tell him to read al-Fatiha, he has a problem. Tell him anything about the religion, he has a problem. Yet he is unbelievably knowledgeable. So this knowledge is getting him nowhere. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, those people, the first one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger called, the meaning of it, people in the market. What are they doing? Arrogantly doing what they're doing. Yelling and screaming. Disputing and arguing and fighting. Missing salahs and misses prayers. And come to the masjid late 4 times that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put a cutoff time where you have to be there. So these people are, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, kal himar. What does the himar do? Sluggish, slow, doesn't understand, and doesn't benefit. And a horrible example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Why? Because if he has books, he's not benefiting. Well, we know the importance of fajr, prayer in the masjid. And we know the importance of Isha prayer in the masjid. And we know the importance of being in the Jumu'ah on time. How many people doing it? And where are they? Exactly what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the market, the majority, they are buying and selling and doing all of those things far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Worse than that, a person coming to the masjid and talks. Starts talking. Let it be salamu alaykum. Let it be marhaba kif halak. This is horrible. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, man takallama yawm al-jum'ah wal-imamu yakhtub fahuwa kal-himar yahmilu asfara wal-ladhi yakulu lahu ansib la jum'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, a person who talks the day of Jumu'ah inside the masjid, and this is not with the imam, with the people, is like a donkey This is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, even if you say assalamu alaykum. He is like a donkey carrying books, meaning you know your Jum'ah is not going to be accepted, yet you continue to talk and not listen. Why? Because when you talk, you're not paying attention to the khatib, which makes another dangerous aspect of it. You come to the Jum'ah to get knowledge and benefit from that knowledge and apply it, and you are not getting that knowledge. It's like you came, you did not benefit the way you're supposed to. You're coming to fulfill a hadith, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives the person al-jum'ah ila al-jum'ah kaffara lima baynahuma. Friday to Friday erases the sins in between. So this is a wonderful opportunity for you to erase your sins and get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet you came and you started talking, you lost the benefit that you're coming to get it here. It's like a donkey carrying books and did not benefit from it. You came to the Jumu'ah, you prayed, but you went home empty-handed. Why? Because you talked. And look how dangerous that is. Also, as one of the companions mentioned, علقمة ابن عبد الله قال جلست قريبا من ابن عمر رضي الله عنه فجاء رجل من أصحابي فجعل يحدثني والإمام يخطب فلما أكثر قلت له أسكت فلما قضينا الصلاة ذكرت ذلك لابن عمر فقال أما أنت فلا جمعة لك وأما صاحبك فحمار. Should we repeat that? Ibn Umar told him, one of the companions in the masjid, his friend came, Salaamu Alaikum, Kif Halak, how are you? Marhaba, kada, start telling him the story of his life. Just like when you go to Aza, people are talking business and meeting one another and exchanging cards and doing everything, and we say we are giving support to the person because he lost his mom or his dad, and we are the farthest from doing that. We're going to chit chat and drink coffee and eat dates, and that's what it appears to me, at least Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. So you come to the Jum'ah, you are sitting, another person comes and tells you the story of his life. Now you don't know what to do. You're quiet, or that companion was quiet. Then finally he had it up. He said, Ya huskut. Please be quiet. At the end of the salah, he came to Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu. He said, this is what happened. Look what Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu said. He said, as for you, because you said uskut, be quiet, it's like no benefit from your prayer. You prayed, it's recorded, you prayed, but how much you get paid? Zero. Because you said uskut. As for your friend, he's a donkey. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu told him, you have no benefit of your salah because you said uskut. As for your friend, he's a donkey because he's not coming with an intention to benefit from the day of Jumu'ah or to come and seek knowledge that you are supposed to seek in a day like this when, yani, unfortunately, the majority of the people, brothers and sisters, on Friday, the khutbah is probably the only thing that they hear the whole week. So imagine yourself, half an hour or so, you come and you don't pay attention to it and you don't have much information. Or half an hour you come so late to it, you don't catch the beginning or the end. Is this a person who really understands the purpose of his existence? Is this a person مخلوق؟ هل هذا يعني ممكن أن يكون إنسان فهمان الهدف من الخلق؟ فهمان أنه مخلوق لعبادة الله سبحانه وتعالى؟ هل هذا الإنسان فهمان أهمية يوم الجمعة؟ هل هذا الإنسان سمع في قول الله سبحانه وتعالى فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون؟ This is the best for you if you only know. Why can't you know? When you know you come and all of your sins for a whole week are forgiven. When you come and attend the Jumu'ah prayer, the best of the days in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited you to buy and sell during Friday because of the importance of the khutbah, not the salah, the khutbah. Because a lot of people, they come, oh, alhamdulillah, I prayed, yeah. You caught what? You caught the last thing, probably 5 minutes or so, maybe you are upset. Imagine one person came and complained to me one time that I finished the khutbah early. He is used to me. Usually I go overboard a little bit, 5 minutes or so. He said, you usually finish at 2:05. You made me miss the prayer. Can you imagine? I made him miss the prayer because I finished at 2:05. So he's coming for the prayer. He's not coming for the khutbah. Is this what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said? Is this why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the Jumu'ah prayer instead of 4 rak'ah, 2 rak'ah? What is the importance of the khutbah in the sights of people with the hasanat that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala too? Brothers and sisters, Surah Al-Jumu'ah and Surah Al-Munafiqun is our topic. The worst two examples set in the Quran. Al-Kalb wal-Himar. Aswa mathalain fi kitab Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa kilayhima madroobun لمن علم ولم يعمل. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. الحمد لله، حمد الشاكرين وحمد الصالحين. الحمد لله حمدا يليق بجلاله وعظيم سلطانه. أسوأ مثالين ضربهم الله سبحانه وتعالى عن العالم الذي لا يعمل وعن الناس ليوم القيامة وعن الجاهل لهدف الوجود في هذه الدنيا. Two horrible examples. Come as close as you can, brothers. Inshallah, you get the reward for your brothers to find a seat. He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in those two examples, related many things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to know why you're here and wants you to work for the hereafter. And if you look at the signs of the Day of Judgment, you see many of those signs take place while people involved in dunya. I'll give you some example. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تقوم الساعة والرجل يحلب اللقحة فما يصل الإناء إلى فيه حتى تقوم أي الساعة والرجلان يتبايعان الثوب فما يتبايعانه حتى تقوم أي الساعة والرجل يليط في حوضه فما يصدر حتى تقوم أي الساعة. يعني ساعة is going, the day of judgment is going to start. A person milking his sheep, he doesn't get to get the drink to his mouth. Boom, day of judgment starts. A person fixes the container or the thing that he made for his animals to drink water. Boom, before he even puts water in it for his animals, day of judgment starts. And another example, people are buying and selling. I give you the merchandise and before we exchange the money and the merchandise, the day of judgment starts. كذلك الفسيلة, تغرس في الفسيلة. You are planting something. Before you benefit from that, the day of judgment starts. So this dunya is taking us far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this dunya is making people so attached to it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to remind you and me. Surah Al-Jumu'ah tells you the importance of Friday. And the importance of seeking knowledge and applying and benefiting from that knowledge. And to leave work. ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. والله if you reflect on that ayah you'll never be late. If you just open your mind and your ears to the wording of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, خير لكم. What are you looking for this life? You're looking for خير, you're looking for good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, good is not staying in work, at work. Good is not earning more money at the expense of being in the masjid on time. That's not where good is if you only know. If you only trust and believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you know the command and you want to adhere to it, it's not the best choice for you. When I want to choose something, what do I do? What's a recommendation? Make istikhara, right? Why do I make istikhara? So I know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the all-knowing, He will choose the best for me. He's telling you the best is to be here, not at work. Yes, close the shop. If you have to, close it. Arrange something. ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. This is the best for you, if you only know. The second surah, Surah Al-Munafiqun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala basically talking about hypocrites. Why? What's the relationship between Friday and the hypocrites? Because hypocrites, brothers and sisters, don't come on Friday. Or they come very late, just like Fajr and Isha. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, be careful. You are taking a quality from the hypocrites. Hypocrites don't talk good about the sunnah. They don't talk good about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Be careful. Hypocrites look, mashallah, but deep inside, nothing. Don't do that. Don't fake your knowledge and look somebody important, and don't be like the hypocrites. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala finished it by saying, spend from that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given you before death comes and you start wishing. So these two important surahs, keep them in your mind, brothers and sisters. Surah Al-Jumu'ah and Surah Al-Munafiqun, recited today, and we will recite it inshallah to revive a sunnah. I'm sure it's been a long time that we have done that. We always recite Sabbih Ismi Rabbika Al-A'la and Hataka Hadidul Ghashiyah. Time wise, one is bigger than the other, but the time is the same. Brothers and sisters, just before conclusion, inshallah, on the 22nd of this month, February 22nd, inshallah, we will have an annual fundraising for the masjid here, so we can inshallah finish putting up the walls inshallah for our masjid that we have been trying for a while. So inshallah will be a wonderful start to participate. February 22nd at the Sheraton Hotel next to the ballpark here in Arlington, Sheraton Hotel, February 22nd. I want inshallah all of you to be there, all of you to show support, all of you to make us move from this small area and go to a better area, inshallah. More space, more activities, more things that we can, inshallah, plan for our youth. Spend from that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given you. These are houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best spot on earth. So benefit from the knowledge, benefit from understanding the Quran that tells you to spend, and this is how to show that your faith is there by spending from that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given you. Allahumma aati nufusana taqwaha wa zakkiha anta khayru man zakkaha anta waliyuha mawlaha. Rabbana aatina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk wa aqimu as-salah.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.